message, just in case. Something terrible is happening in this hotel. Nigel has gone, I don't know where. He was behind me and then, well, he's gone. Read my journal, if you haven't already. We should never have come here. We were not prepared. We discovered something using the thermoscanner. I've written the settings in a safe place. Upstairs, in the bathroom, find them. We have sealed the chamber back up, but it's only temporary. If you find the settings, you may gain access and perhaps find Nigel. Please, God, let him be all right. I cannot connect either online or by phone. I'll have to venture beyond this room. I think it's gone. It was outside the door. Now is the time to make a move. Wish me luck.
others, unless they spy my blood, they could follow it. My own blood shall bring them to us. Shut up, Will. Keep thy mouth sealed, for they could hear us. We keep quiet. We keep still. Oh, my blood spills. Find me some rags. I must stop the bleeding. Damn shot. No, they won't find us.
And that program is repeated on Saturday at 2:15 p.m. With the time 11:30 GMT, we join Stephen Ashurst for a new series of This Working Life. Good morning, and welcome to This Working Life with me, Stephen Ashurst. Each episode will be focusing on individuals who have chosen interesting and sometimes strange careers for themselves. This week we interview Polly White, a self-confessed ghost hunter, and Joanne Coles, a promoter of traditional Yorkshire puddings. And finally, Philip Luzek, an organic bird food farmer from Brittany. Okay, firstly, Polly, good morning. Why such an odd profession?
Well, firstly, I don't like to think of it as odd. Really, it is such like another science, sadly a rather ignored or ridiculed one. The routines, practices, recording and experiments follow the same rules and criteria. I like to refer to it as an alternative science, rather like you have alternative religions and medicine.
When did you first become interested in, to coin your phrase, the alternative sciences?
Funnily enough, I was doing my foundation course at the time for a regular physics degree. I had a supernatural experience and became interested in the cause and reason.
Care to elaborate?
Of course. Well, I was at Sussex University at the time, and had been for 3 months. Some friends and I were talked into trying a Ouija board session. Naturally, I at first thought the idea ridiculous, but went along with the others, if only to scoff at them when nothing happened. But something did happen.
Care to elaborate?
A lengthy and sustained conversation with an intelligent spectral phenomenon. It quite shook me up at first, and then I became fascinated. Within a month, we had all dropped out of our courses and were seeking alternatives. Regular physics just didn't seem rewarding or exciting after that night.
You did find an alternative course. Would you like to talk about it?
Yes. I was reading a science fiction magazine and saw an advertisement for a new group of experimental courses at Weymouth University. They are the brainchild of Henry Cuttle, who actually lectures on everything from the supernatural to warp science theories. It was partly Henry's influence that got us the doubt and experiment.
This is your new project, yes?
Yes, sponsored by Haddon Industries. Myself and fellow student Nigel Danvers are spending the next couple of weeks, and possibly more, in the abandoned station and hotel just outside the village. Sadly, the buildings are about to undergo major redevelopment to convert them into a bar, club and restaurant. This is a pity as the building is essentially a living museum. The owners, the Crabtree Estate, have kept the place as sealed as possible. They lost their son in 1947. He disappeared from the hotel.
Yes, I remember reading something about that. He disappeared, didn't he? Along with several others.
Yes, all on the same night. They were not the only ones either. As recent as the early 80s, people have been disappearing from around that area.
Do you believe they're connected?
It would be less realistic to think that they are not. It's too much of a coincidence.
The police don't agree with that theory, do they?
No, they still state that George Crabtree abducted the guests and staff after midnight and disposed of the bodies. This is, quite frankly, ridiculous. Where are the bodies? Where is George Crabtree? Did he dispose of himself as well?
What is your theory?
I haven't got one, yet. We're hoping the experiment will provide some clues.
How are you going about it?
Haddon Industries have lent us a wonderful array of gadgets and equipment, some experimental, others obvious, CCTV, microphones, and an operating system designed especially. We're very excited about it.
It does sound terribly exciting. Is there a possibility that you could return to tell us some of your results?
Certainly. I look forward to it.
Thank you. That sounds brilliant. Okay, over to you, Joanne. Yorkshire puddings.
are you looking at me like that? I be Tom Oliver. Though what business is of thee? If thou know best, you better leave this place. Well, I was shot, wasn't I? I did but nearly hit him. Bloody pistol. Well, Thomas did say it was busted. I don't believe it. God wasn't on my side this night. It feels late. Too late, maybe. You better leave now.
this isn't funny. You weirdo, good night.
Chinese food this side of Dorchester. This is an automated service. Please hold the line while we check your number. You have a standing order with us. Would you like us to deliver your usual order? Please press the star key twice for yes, or press 1 to make a new order. Your usual order is number 15. You have now ordered number 15. Sorry, but the shop is closed. We close at 11:30 p.m. You are too late. Good night.